University of Engineering and Management, Jaipur. We'll be discussing a very important, very interesting topic, image steganography. You might be knowing that means many of us are doing the steganography since our childhood, like we are writing the messages in a secret code or a very secret message in invisible ink we used to write so that another person are not able to see it. It's the same kind of thing in computer science right now. So applications are broad. So I'll request Professor Jyoti Khandelwal to please take over from this point. Madam, kindly continue.
Thank you, sir. So very good afternoon, first of all, to everyone. My name is Jyoti Khandelwal. I'm assistant professor in computer science and engineering department in University of Engineering Management, Jaipur. So today I'm going to discuss about the image steganography, a brief introduction. Before starting, I'd like to thank the IMUEM management, my HOD, and all my seniors to give me this opportunity to share my knowledge with all of you. So this is a very interesting topic, and just go with this, go with the flow, and then we can understand with the easy method how this steganography is going to be working in computer science. So this is the first of all, the thing is coming when we are talking about sending the data from one place to another place. The thing is coming in front of us is information system security. We can say the steganography and other method, those who are sending the data from one place to another place, they are using the concept of information system security. The objective of information system security is based on three objectives. The first one is confidentiality, then integrity, and then availability. It means whenever you send the data from one place to another place, no other person, those who are not authorized to access your data, they are not able to see it. Second thing is integrity. This is a very important feature because whenever I done any changes in my data, it should be available and visible with the both parties, for the sender and for the receiver. And third one is availability. We are given two properties for making our data available and to providing to the authentic person. The point is, if availability is not available, another two objectives are actually not required. So these three points are always work when we are talking about to securing our data. So let's just start with the steganographic basic definition. As the sir is already told, then whenever we want to hide a message and want to that nobody apart from the intent recipient know about my existence of my secret information, there the concept of steganography is came. The thing is, steganography is divided in different category on the basis of the carriers like text, image, audio, and video. Here today I'm going to discuss about the image steganography, but the point is from where this concept is coming. The steganography word is come from Greek word steganos and graphics. It means we need a covered writing. So it means simple word, if I just want to tell you what is steganography, it means I want to hide the existence of my information into another media. What is image steganography? The digital image are made by the pixels, and the collection and arrangement of these pixels create a raster data. So the images are generally two types, 8-bit and 24-bit. Why I'm saying this 8-bit and 24-bit? The 8-bit images are the grayscale images. It means you have to hide, you are having black and white color only. So you have only 8-bit to hide your data. But when we are going for further things, like if I'm going to use the color images, I need to use 24-bit images. So there is red, green, and blue are the primary colors. Whenever I choose any image to hide my data, if the size of image is bigger, of course, it can contain more information to hide. But problem is, whenever the data is containing in a higher quantity, it can be detectable also. So for that, we need to perform some compression technique to avoid that detection. So I hope the steganography and image steganography is clear to you for a part. Okay, so let's just discuss what is the difference between the past and present steganography. You can see there are lots of different methods are available with the past and past steganography. Invisible link, like using the slave scale for writing your information and sending that particular messenger to one place to another place. Vex table, it is just visible like an image portrait, and inside of that you are writing your secret message. And the null cipher, where the every words starting word first alphabet is hiding your secret information. So there is lots of things are available, but at the time the message are sending physically by some messenger. But nowadays we are sending our data by the digital medium. So that for this, I need some computer software and some algorithm with the password to send my data to one place to another. To make you understand about what is actually the past steganography method, I have one video with me. So the video is containing how the slaves are used to sending the data from one place to another. So sir, I request you please play that video so that everybody can understand.
Ma'am, you kindly share, if you can start the video from your side.
Okay.
From the share button, from share.
So, sir, in the PPT also it will work like this?
No. You start the video.
Okay.
It will not be having the audio. You start from the uploaded version.
From your side.
Go to the panel on the right hand side. Show screen. Show screen. Now over there the options will be coming. Sharing is there, no? Sharing?
There is show screen, stop, give it, and
show screen. Below that, there is a menu. When you click on a screen, okay. There is a menu.
Okay, fine. So it's, I think, working.
Yes, it's working. You are muted, madam.
Okay. So now it's unmuted?
Yes, yes. You will start the PPT again.
So now the thing is coming. The previously the time taken part is very much here, and secondly we cannot trust to anyone, also the slaves can betray us. So that's why the nowadays the information is sent by the digital media. So sir, now my screen is visible?
Yes, yes, it is visible.
Okay. So the thing is, sometime when we talking about this technography, there is little bit confusion is coming on mind. Those who are already doing the research in this technography, they are facing this, that this techno, what is the difference between this technography and cryptography? One more word is coming. I'm going to ask that word to you. Then first of all, we discuss about what is the confusion actually. The thing is, both the cryptography and its technography methods are used to hide and protect our secret data. But the difference is, when we are talking about the cryptography, the data must be unreadable. So it means the meaning of data is changed. But in this technography, we are just hiding the existing. As you can see in the picture also, that her lady is, she is just sleeping very calmly because the money is under the sink and under her mattress. But when you are hiding your money inside some vault or something, you need multiple layers of security to save your money. So this is the simple difference between this technography and cryptography. Now the question is coming, sometime when we are using in the world also, we are watching so many kind of letterhead and many things. And with my PPT also, you can see there is a background available. So the thing is called the watermarking. Now, my question is, which one can be used as a watermark in Word document? A text, an image, or both A and B, and none of these? You can use your chat box and give that answer. So responses are coming.
Yeah, I received some responses like Rups saying C options is given. Yeah. Sujata Bose, both.
Then both Ankit Kumar
Sharma, yeah, both A and B. Ankit Kumar Sharma is writing answer is C. Uttam Narendra Thakur, both A and B. Then both A and B by Dr. Udit Chawla. Option C, Amartya Chakraborty. And then all C's are there from Gautam Paul. Let me read out. Yeah, Gautam Paul, Dr. Subrata Chattopadhyay, Dr. Umesh Das, Kaustav Mandal, Abhishek Haldar. Then Amlan Pratim Hazarika is writing B option. And Siddhartha Datta C, Jyoti Anand C, Biswajit Bani both. Then Dr. Latarani option C. Then Roma Roy Chaudhary A, Sanjoy Gupta C. So it's a mixed response, but most of the responses are in C or both.
Answer like is the correct option also, both A and B. The point is coming, but sometimes the pupils are writing like a B also, like A is not writing. If you remember, like in the Word file, we can input a watermark where we can write your name also. The watermark is just about to show that this document is belong to me, not to the other person. Same as our university has also done, it will paste the logo in back of the letterhead and everything. So the watermarking is the another category. I think you, all those who are saying that is only B, they can also retry with the Word document and try to use the text also as a watermark. So this is the third category. Where we are learning about the research process, we are facing three difficulties. What is technography? What is cryptography? What is watermarking? Now, I think it's now clear. Now, the thing is coming. Now I'm going to talk about what is the key elements of image steganography. The key element of image steganography is cover medium, secret message, and third one is the SIGO key, which is the actual important process, or we can say the steganography is depend upon SIGO key. So the SIGO key is not like just you are performing some kind of algorithm and you can perform it. You can do it in multiple way. Even you can do two or three level of protection on it by using the scrambling of the pixel, by changing the rotation, by changing the intensity of a pixel. So the image steganography key part is a very important part. To make you understand about again more about the steganography, I have an example. As you can see, the Osama bin Laden is known as a steganography master. In Berlin 2011, the Al-Qaeda members are arrested by the police. So they find out one video where 141 hidden text files are available. So the FBI director Louis Freeh, he speak so many times that the terrorists are using some kind of different methods and something, but nobody notice him. And at the end, what happened? In 9/11 terrorist attack is happened in the USA. After this attack, one news is released in USA where the government agencies are asking to the computer expert to understand how Osama bin Laden interact with his team members by using the encryption pattern. So in this case, video steganography is utilized. Now the another method, so many of you are already seen the Hollywood season Prison Break, where a younger brother want his brother to out of the jail. So in that case, he is taken one tattoo, and on that tattoo, all the maps related to the pipelines is available so that he can escape from that jail. So you can see. And no requirement of the audio. There is only one image is coming, you can see, for that steganography. These are the pipeline designs available in the tattoo. But the point is how he is going to understand, because he is the person who is designed this tattoo, and he know that is what is the designing pattern he used. The designing pattern here is work just like a key. So you can see this is the basic steganography model available here, where I already told you about what is the cover file, what is the secret message. There is an encoder available where the key is generated. By using the key, we are generating the Stego object. This Stego object is traveled through the communication channel. And when it reaches to the decoder, that secret message is extracted. So this is a basic steganography model, but there are, according to the research, there are lots of models are available. Because here I am talking about the image steganography, you can say the Stego image which is created is a Stego image. Within the extraction process, we will find out the cover medium and the embedded message. And in this model, you can see there is a pre-processing and post-processing technique we are applied to make our sending our data in a robust and invisible way to the transmission medium. Then the third process, you can see here is a wavelet transformation operation is performed on the image. In the place of steganography, I replace this by the wavelet transform, because this is a method belong to the image steganography core part. Now just discuss about what is actually it is going to be for. For example, I'm having one cover image and one secret image. Now the here only the secret image I want to hide in this cover image. The size of the image can be anything, like here 256 by 256. We can use 128, 64 by 64. According to your requirement, you can choose the image. The thing which is, I'm already told you that in some models, there are pre-processing things are available. So what is the meaning of pre-processing? Maybe in the first case, I'm only having one cover image. But the point is, if I'm having so many cover images, so how can I identify that this image is best for my secret image? So for that, I need to perform some operations. The operations are MSC and the PSNL. How they are going to be calculated, I'm going to tell you. But the thing is, you can see here, this is the secret image, this one is a secret image. After pre-processing, this cover image is coming for this, and this cover image is coming for this. You can see the both are the image are equal. If in the database, the same secret image is available, sorry, so you can select as a cover image so that the better invisibility is available, because man behind the man, it's just only increase your intensity of your pixel, nothing else. You do not need to do any kind of further steganography or something for that. But you can see here the MSE value, when both the images are equal, the mean square error is zero, and the PSNR, the peak signal noise ratio, is infinity. So how we can calculate them? This is a mean square error. For example, these are the two matrices, because we know the image is in a 2D dimension, so there are some pixels available. So that we are just calculating them column wise, like 527, 148, 903, like that. I'm applying this formula, and after that formula, I find out the MSE. So how the MSE is actually affected your process? Just see this example. When the original image pixels are rastered by some other way, like they are scrambled by some other way, the pixels are changed the position and it is represent like this. So in that case, it means the MSE show when both the images, if any two images are not similar, in that case, MSE is always increased. Mean square error is always increased. But when both images are equal, the MSE is going to zero. Next thing is coming the PSNR. The PSNR here, this is the formula. For the PSNR, first I need to identify the MSE value. So you can see the comparative study here. If both the images, if the original image and encrypted image, if both the images are not similar, so in that case, MSE is going to high and PSNR is going to low. So now go to the pre-processing method, and you can think in your mind, the PSNR for that paper image, for this paper image, is maximum match this Lena image. So PSNR when high, we have to select that particular image from my database. But when both the images are equal, so MSE going to zero and the PSNR is going to infinity. It means there is no difference between both the images. This is a log diagram, how this is going to be worked. Now the point is coming, how can I identify which PSNR value is suitable for me? By the so many research, there are some written lines are available that if the stego image PSNR value is in between 30 to 50 dB, we can accept that image, and it can travel from the channel and it will be safe from the attackers. But MSP should, like PSNR, should be in between 30 to 50 after converting into the stego image. Now, as I told you that the images are two types, like a gray image and the color image. So for understand the second method, second step of steganography, we have to understand the channel. The image is divided in multiple channel in the case of RGB, red, green and blue. And the grayscale image divided is in three parts. Generally, it is having actually the one channel, because only the one color is available. So in that case, we can, according to the intensity of a pixel, we can distribute them in a three part. So on, if I want to chase, do some scrambling on this thing, scrambling, it means changing the location of the pixel. So if I just want to do the scrambling, in the case of RGB, I need to perform on each and every channel. But in the grayscale, this is not required, because all the things are available in the 1D array, and you can perform, convert it, and do whatever you want to do accordingly, according to the scramble method. But this one is a little bit difficult. So here is a scrambling example. You can rotate a matrix, like a circular matrix is like circularly I rotate the matrix, 1, 2, 3, 4 is taking the position here. And if the matrix is bigger, I can take 1, 2, and 3 cycle, like whatever the possibilities are available. So the pixel actual position is converted to another location. So the images after scrambling are represent like this. So you can see here is also the numbers are changing. So we are just changing the location of the pixels, and at the time of extraction, again, I need to perform the reverse method to extract that mask, that original secret image. So here you can see another block diagram. You can use a random permutation also. This is the inbuilt function in MATLAB. In the presentation also, sir told about the random permutation, how it's going to provide the answers in the MATLAB presentation. There are some categories of steganography, like the special domain and the transform domain. The special domain are very simple, like we have to work on each and every pixel. But when we are talking about the transform domain, I need to work on the amplitude and phase of that particular signal, image signal. So this is so much famous nowadays. And this one, LSB, is the evergreen methodology we are using in the image steganography. So how the LSB is going to work, I'm just giving the example of LSB and the DWT here because less of time. So you can see, this is the RGB image, red, green, and blue for every pixel. This is the hidden message I want to hide. So I'm choosing the last position to hide my message. So after that, there is a little bit difference is coming in the original image because I'm directly substituting the value. But in case of DWT, and we can say the transform domain, I need to decompose my image according to the filters, like low low filter, low high filter, high low, and high high filter. So from these four parts, I can choose any decomposed part and I can embed my data. So you can see when I done the decomposition one level, so the all the data which is actually belong representing the cover image is available in the low low bank subdivision. But if I just want to do it further, I can decompose the allel part only in a four part, only this part. So again, the four images are coming. So I can again choose. Why this has happened? Because you can see in this level, the image size is bigger. But if I want to make the size small, so in that case, the optimization is directly happened here. So the image size is always decreased. So you can choose any of the subdivision, and you can embed your data, and at the end, the stego image is here. This is the secret image. This is the again the embedding and extraction process. You can see here the inverse, whatever you are using for embedding, the inverse process are applied for outputting. So on again, the host image are reached, and again at the time of extraction, I perform the same things in the reverse manner so that I can find out the hidden image. So this is the method of SVD. You can say here the SVD method is here. Actually, we know that the engineering is totally depend upon the mathematics. We cannot do anything without the mathematics. So in that case, you can see the image matrix is divided in three parts, U, S, and V. V raised to power T is a transpose. So it will be generate three matrices to decompose our image further. So after the TWT also, you can decompose your image again in a three matrices. So, and the embedding extraction process seems like this. This is the pre-processing cover image. I created the scramble image for this image. This thing is actually going to embed in this, and this Stego image is generated. At the time of extraction process, the extracted secret image is generated, which is similar to the original secret image. Again, for the another example, this thing is happening. But the point is, the pupils are always thinking about how to steal someone's data. So there are so many attackers are available in the channel, those who want to extract your secret information. So for that, they are doing some attacks. So there are lots of category in image spectrography, like Gaussian low pass, median. Actually, the attacks in a Stego image, I understand this thing, like they are divided into category. Like there are so many filters. There are so many filters. So somebody want to try to make your image somehow disturbed. So that when the image reaches to you, you confuse. No, 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 it's not belongs to me. So attacker always want to do this thing. And whenever the Stego image is attacked, sometime when we want to extract the data, the data is represented like this. There is an ANSI, you can see. This is a normal correlation. So in that case, it is equals to one or nearly equals to one. That image, extracted image is acceptable. So in that case, you can see this one is acceptable. This one is acceptable, but these are not acceptable. Sometimes we are using to identify that actually how much my original image and extracted image are similar. So for that, we are using some graphical analysis. So here I'm taking only one example, that I'm creating a histogram for both the images. This is for original and this is for extracted. And if you're going to check it, if here the two, both of the image are equal, right? But if there are some difference, should be like visible in this histogram, so that you can identify how much your extracted image is different to the original secret. So this is all about the image spectrography. I just shared my knowledge with you. So thank you so much, everyone. So.
Yeah, thank you, madam. I'm just looking into if there are certain questions. First, I will show the post.
Yes, sir.
So first, the post I am launching. This is what is the process of hiding text, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I request all the members to kindly vote. It's already reached 40%. The question is, what is the process of hiding text within an image called? Steganography, encryption, spyware, keystroke logging. Already 45 seconds are there. I'm waiting just to finish up to 1 minute. The voting today reached up to 58%. So I'm closing the vote and sharing the results. So you can see that 68% have voted for steganography. Then 31% encryption, 1% for spyware, and 1% for keystroke logging. What is your comment, madam?
So the question is related to hiding the data. So we can say the steganography is a correct answer. So the encryption as a pattern is used with the another techniques also, but the hiding is just like we are using first technique.
Okay, thank you. So let me check if any question is there. Okay, so one question is there from Jyoti Anand madam. How pixels are selected in LSV method of image steganography?
So according to whatever the knowledge I gained from the research paper and all, the thing is, if you want a sequence, like if you want a sequence to hide your pixels or your image data, you can use directly the form. Just like you can use the last bits of RGB channels. If this is a color image, you can use a direct for loop. But the point is, according to the new research also, they are using the randomization method to select the bits. So in that case, if you are using the randomized method, you can generate a key, and according to the key, you can put your data. And secondly, you can give the chance to the key only. He can like in the process only selecting the pixel for hide your data. Like the encryption, selecting the pixel for hiding your data is done by the automatic process of key. So randomly select. Yes,
okay. Okay. I'm not finding any other. Yeah. One question is there from Dr. G. Uma Devi. In huge size of data, which technique is suitable?
If actually the point is, if we are having so many databases, like I already done this pre-processing part with the LSV, with the special domain and the transform domain, the transform domain techniques are more feasible and less time consuming. So we can use the, we can go for the transform domain.
Okay. So I'm requesting all persons over here, all participants, to post their questions if possible. I'm not finding any other question, madam.
Okay,
so thank you, madam. Thank you, Jyoti madam, and thank you all the participants over here. Thank you all IEM UEM family members to attend this. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you, madam.